In this episode, two. Okay, in this episode, chain rule is calling you. I'm going to come up with two examples of log and trig functions. How to differentiate using chain rule. Stay tuned. Hey guys, all right, let's handle this one. Looks scary, I know. Don't worry, I'm gonna be by your side and I will take this pain away. Just at the first glimpse, let's figure out. You have a composition, for sure. You have a composite function. Let's figure out what your function is made of. You have power, so this is your outer function. This power, you have a ln, you have natural logarithm, and you have something inside, you have argument. So power. So chain rule for derivative, divide dx. So chain rule says, you take the derivative of outside function of that power. So you use a power rule, this power 2, you bring it out front is the coefficient, leaving all side alone, as is. And you reduce this power by 1, so 2 minus 1 becomes just 1, so it's invisible 1, we can ignore it, so you don't have to write. Right, now, we're not done yet, because you have this composition function, this term gets multiplied. Now, what you have more, ask yourself. You have natural logarithm. Okay. Think of table of derivatives. The derivative of natural logarithm is 1 over that argument. So your argument is not x, it's 3x minus 2, in fact. So 1 over 3x minus 2. So this is the derivative of natural logarithm of 3x minus 2. And, surprise, surprise, we are not done yet. Because if it were x, we would write 1 over x and we are done at this stage, at this point. But because you have this linear 3x minus 2 inside, this term gets multiplied again, chain rule. Gets multiplied by the derivative of 3x minus 2. This is kind of double chain rule, if you like, if you wish. Alright, now at this stage, we're done. Now all you need to do is just simplify it down. For this term, so you have 3x minus 2, the derivative, kind of elementary, basic, is just 2. They would leave you with 3. As the derivative of negative 2 is just 0, the derivative of x is 1. Just rewrite it. These 2 and 3 get multiplied, becomes 6. One thing I would like to just point out that do not mix up, don't get confused between this argument. So this argument belongs natural logarithm, and this is 3x minus 2. This is kind of separate expression, so you cannot combine, you cannot cancel, okay? I mean, it's kind of tempting to probably cancel them out. Don't do, erase any thought from your mind of simplifying in this manner. So you cannot cancel at this point. So why? Because this is your argument that actually belongs to a ln function. This is 3x minus 2. So you could leave your answer in that form. Moving on. How about this one? Again, looks spooky, I know. I feel your pain, guys. Anyway, let's deal with this one. Let's figure out, first of all, what do we have? What do we have? We have a root, which is your outer function, actually. Now, what you have inside? You have sine of something. And finally, you have linear. Again, looks like, seems like we have to use chain rule at least twice. Yes, double chain rule. Go ahead. Y prime. Your outer function is a root, the derivative of root. Okay, for me, true confession. Okay, I remember that the derivative of root is just 1 over 2 root. If you don't remember this one, actually it derives from a basic power rule. If you rewrite your root as a half power, so it becomes just 1 over 2 the half power of this inside expression. But you can derive it like from a basic power rule. Nothing wrong with this. So 1 over 2 root of, so I have to keep this expression as is, so not change sine whatever we have inside, namely 5x plus 1, gets multiplied by, now sine goes next, trig functions, so switch to trig, derivative of trig, derivative of sine. Derivative of sine is cosine. Write it. Cosine of 5x plus 1. We are not done yet, as we said, okay? It's tempting to finish, but not yet. So you have linear, the last one. We have to take the derivative of 5x plus 1. So the derivative of 5x plus 1 is going to be just 5. It gets multiplied by 5. Now, we are done with all these derivatives. Just the last step, just clean it up a little bit, slick it up. So use some algebra to make it more simpler. So 5 goes on top, cosine goes on top. Okay, let me write it as a fraction. Two root, again one little tip, one little bonus tip, of course, do not get confused. So this is 5x plus 1 argument that belongs to cosine. Same 5x plus 1 argument that belongs to sine on bottom. So it might be kind of tempting to erase them, to cancel them. No way. You can't. You cannot. This is different. This is different argument. So they are not. They cannot be canceled each other. So this is your result for this function. So step by step, just make sure that you use chain rule properly and make sure that you take into consideration all parts of your function. Sometimes it gets kind of crazy, it gets more complicated, more sophisticated, especially if your function nested like other function inside. It could be like more triple chain rule, even extreme chain rule, more functions inside. Just keep going, keep multiplying by all these small derivative inside. You will be fine. I hope it does help you. I know, guys, everyone hates maths. But if you like my video, please hit like button. Share with your friends, leave the comment down below and subscribe so you will not miss my new videos. Train your brain.